Hello everyone, welcome back to another video, and in today's video we're diving into Sorted³, which is a brand new take on the Sorted application. We're going to be diving into the resource, the features, the functions, first impressions essentially. We're going to be diving over on the iPhone to demonstrate it. Now it's an iOS only application, it sort of looks like Things 3's younger brother, and it's been a popular one on Product Hunt this week. So guys, without further ado, let's dive in. So, Sorted³ is the third installment of the application, and it claims to allow you to schedule events, tasks, and notes. Now, the application starts very simply. You can essentially use this as a task list, adding event details as well as details to the task to allow you to complete it. Now, there are some special features that I want to dive into that I've been checking out in this first impressions. The first is auto-schedule. Auto-schedule is by far their most impressive feature. Essentially, what you can do is select all of your tasks for the day. Once you're on auto-schedule, what you can do from here is choose a time that you would want it to auto-schedule from, whether that's a specific time or morning, afternoon, and evening. Choosing the buffer time that you want for breaks between tasks, as well as the amount of time duration per task. Once you click all these and have set the settings, you press auto-schedule, and essentially what it does is it maps out your day for you. This is an awesome feature and essentially allows you to plot out your day based on some of the tasks of most importance. So this is quite a smart function for those who just want to plot out their day without having to set all the times up and essentially save you a bit of time. Now it doesn't end here, the gestures work pretty well, and there's this feature called Magic Select. Essentially what you can do is highlight some of your tasks and tweak their time, pushing them forward or backwards, or even pushing the time between them a little bit forward and backward, which makes it a lot easier. Now there is also a third feature that works pretty well. Essentially you can reorganize tasks inside of your list. So for example, if you wanted to split out your task but use certain elements inside of the task, you can do that and create a task using the notes and functions that you've created. So if you've added a checklist in there, you can use all of the text formatting to add all of that great stuff. You can split that out into two tasks. Now the application also touts the ability to have folders, tags, and lists, as well as iCloud sync, dark mode, natural language input, as well as the ability to connect with your calendar. There are also bonus experiences in this, like the guides function is so useful for learning the features. One of the first things I'd have to say about the application is get used to it. It takes a bit of time to understand the application, but the entirety of the application does work well once you've learned it. The application really resonates with those who probably already use Things³. It looks almost identical, but there are a few functions that make it stand out. You can use the calendar a lot more in this application, and it tries to make the act of scheduling tasks a lot more coordinated. Now, inside of this application, they've also included a URL scheme, so that does allow you to connect up with other applications. Now, if I'm honest, this application has impressed me early days. Of course, it's easy to use once you've learned it, and I do think that it's really marketing it towards everyone's to-do list application. The price is pretty reasonable at the moment. It's $9.99 before the 6th of September, and you can unlock that across all of your iOS devices. It is normally about $14.99, which I still think is fairly reasonable for an application like this, especially because it does have a quite a high level of functionality in terms of comparing it to Things³. Now, they do have a 14-day free trial, which means you don't actually have to sign up. They also have a view only mode, so you can go in there and enjoy it. Now, for those who have signed up and have maybe purchased Sorted² you can get Sorted³ for free, which is a good gesture from the team. Now, my recommendation for those who want to use Sorted³ is really for mobile only professionals looking to avoid forking out $49.99 for Things³. But if you wanted to go iOS only on Things³, it would actually only be $30, which is $20 more, which is where this application is trying to target. Now, I would say this is much more relaxed method of organizing tasks with the ability to use advanced tools. And I think this looks great on iPad in the previews, and it's something that I think a lot of people will be flocking to. So guys, let's keep an eye on Sorted³. These were my first impressions, but I'd love to hear your comments below. Let me know in the comments what you think about Sorted³. And if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. And if you're brand new here, do subscribe to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Anyway, guys, I will see you guys in a future video. Cheers.